Can anyone of you give feedback? Are you able to see the Excel sheet?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in the previous few lectures, I covered the measures of central tendency and mainly three, the arithmetic mean, median and norm. In addition to that, I also discussed the computational method of quartile, first quartile and third quartile, and recently I have uploaded the video, and I would request you all to go through the videos, and if there is any difficulty, please do discuss with me in the next class, and I am always requesting you to provide me any time on, say, Friday, Saturday, preferably on Saturday, so that I can have some additional or extra classes also. Today, I will discuss the concept of measure of variation. It is also called measures of dispersion. There are other names also. And all these measures, like measures of central tendency, gives us information about the central data value, that is the representative data value. And when I say representative, you all know that that data which represents the whole data set means that is the data value. We can infer that most of the data value will be closer to that data value. So, mean, median, mode, they can provide information about the representativeness of the data value, but how far they are really representative, their reliability in representing the reliability of the measures of central tendency depends on how scattered the data are, how data are distributed. If all the values are same, then there is no dispersion, all the data are same. But if data values are different, then they are having some dispersion. Today, I will discuss the concept of this dispersion or variation in the data set, and how to compute some of the measures of dispersion. Let us begin with these four data sets that I have mentioned here, and you are not able to see the data values because I have changed the font color to white. So, all these four data sets are having the mean of 5. So, what we will infer that, say, these are four subgroups of students from your class and all have taken the same test. We will say that overall A, B, C, D groups are comparable because they are having the same mean score of 5. But now I am changing the form, this white to automatic. Now you see the actual data. See the system. Our inference that most of the students have scored near 5 is really correct. Or in fact, almost all students have scored the same score, that is 5. But now look at this data. Do you think that our inference that 5 is the representative data value for this data set? Most of them have failed the test, they have scored 0, and one obtained 25 out of 25. This was the maximum possible score. And because of this single student, the whole group mean is 5. So here the data is quite scattered. There is variation in the data set. Look here, there are two scores, 20 and 5, remaining are 0. It is still very much scattered, but less scattered than this. and look at this data set. This is still, so there is no cut, no variance, no variation, no dispersion in this data set. There is very high dispersion in this data set, and there is a great dispersion in this data set. And if we are just not having this information and we were having the information of the mean only, then we might draw some wrong inference about the four groups and the representativeness of the measures of central tendency, particularly mean, becomes questionable. So this is one of the biggest use of the measures of variation. And how we can assess this variation? One simple way is that you can say that you select one highest value and one lowest value. In this, the highest and lowest are same. So 5 minus 5 is 0, and there is no dispersion. There is zero dispersion. There is dispersion, and how much dispersion? Simple. That highest value is 25 and lowest is 0. So 25 minus 0 is 25. So this is called range. So range is the most crude measure of assessing or measuring variation in the data set. Here 20 minus 5, 15. So you can say yes, it is scattered, but less scattered. And here highest value is 9 and lowest value is 2. 9 minus 2 is 7. So this is less scattered. But the measure limitation of this measure of dispersion or measure of variance or measure of variation is that it depends on only two data values. Suppose this is 9, I do not touch this, and this is 2, I am not going to touch this, and I am creating another data value here, just putting it 9. This is also, say, mean will not be same, so don't try to guess this. 9. And then 2. Now, the range of this data is 9 minus 2, 7, and the range of this data set is 9 minus 2, 7. But you can see that this is lower scattered, less dispersed than this data set. Why? Because this range is not taking into account all data points, all data values. This is taking into account only two values, the highest and the lowest. So this is not a very good measure. Another measure is suggested by some researchers that extreme values are either very high or very low. So if we can exclude the top 25% higher values and top 25% lower values, and then if we take the range of the remaining 50% value, then that will be more sensitive measure. And this is the base of the concept of quartile deviation. And for this, we calculate two quartiles. The first quartile, which is called Q1. If you will see the video, I have uploaded the video quite late. Therefore, I am extremely sorry. So Q1 and Q3. And I will provide you option to ask questions. So the difference of this 25% cases lie below Q1, 75% cases lie below Q3. So if we take the difference of the Q3 and Q1, so quartile deviation is QD is equal to Q3 minus Q1. Q1, and this whole thing is divided by 2. So this is also called semi-quartile range. This is better than Wren's because it is not taken into account the extreme values like the highest value and the lowest value, but it is taken into account. But again, this is limited because quartile deviation is also dependent on only two values, that is Q3 and Q1. So taking these limitations into account, statistician thought to develop some better measures of variation. Now just think, and I would request you to interact, how we can measure the deviation in a better way. And I will use this data set for computational purpose. So in the meantime, I am calculating midpoint, and I would request to share your views that how we can calculate better estimate. And these are the two names. If you are aware, average deviation and standard deviation, they are better estimate. And a better estimate of measure of variation will be one that takes into account all the data values. So I will do the calculation later. Let us just write a few data values: 4, 5, 8, 2, 6, 8, 9. Now, let us take the mean of this. Average. So average of this data set is 6. If I am going with range, then I will say the highest value is 9 and the lowest value is 2, the range is 7. It is not giving the exact information. I want a measure that takes into account all the data values. Let us label this score as EX. Then one method is that if we will calculate X minus mean, that is X bar, then we are having a reference point, mean is the central value of the data, and we are measuring that from the center how far the different data values are. So let us do this computation. X minus M, and then doing it using the Excel formula, this is X and mean is 6. You can see, just any one of you say that I can know, I am still connected with you. Are you able to hear me?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Thank you. Because I am not seeing your screen, I am seeing my Excel sheet only. This is the major limitation of this Google Meet. So I have done this. This is really a good measure. Now we know that from the entry point, this score is 2 points lower. This score is just 1 point lower than that. This score is 2 points higher than the central value, that is mean. This score is more dispersed because this is 4 points lower than the mean. There is no dispersion in this data because this is lying on the mean like this. And if we can compute the average of this, then that will give the average dispersion. So this is giving you the individual score dispersion or variation. This score is varied this much, this score is varied this much. And if we take the mean of this, then that will give the average deviation, then it will be a good thing. But you, if you know earlier, then it is better, otherwise you will not. Let us just do the sum. And this is 1 property of the mean that look, it is zero. So deviation taken from mean to sum, so sum of the deviations taken from mean is always zero. If the sum is zero, then mean will also be zero. If you are thinking to check, let this time compute the average, not sum. Average is also zero. So does it mean that on the average there is no dispersion? No. Why? Because this is the property of the mean, that whenever we will take difference of the each scores with reference to mean, and when we will sum all these deviations, it will be zero. So how to solve this issue? Because the scores are dispersed, you can see, I am also saying that the scores are dispersed, but because of this mathematical property, statistical property of mean, we will not be able to compute average. So one thing is that we take the mod value, mod ex minus m, and the mod x minus m means we take only the positive difference. So this will become 2, this will become 1, this will become 2 minus 4, the mod of minus 4 is 4, 0 will remain 0, 2 will remain 2 because it is already positive, 3 will remain positive. So if we take the average of this, the average variation is 2. This is average, and this is not much. Here I have written the formula average deviation AD. And what is AD? AD is sum of the mod of the deviations taken from mean. Summation mod x minus x bar divided by n. Unfortunately, this is not given in your syllabus, but I always teach this. So this is average deviation, and we have computed average deviation for this score series. This is 2. Another way of doing the same thing is that to make the values positive, what we have done, we have taken mod. Another thing is that now I am writing this. Let us square this. So x minus m square. So minus 2 square will be 4. Let us do by formula, it will save our time. So minus 2 square is 4, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 2, like this. And these are the squared value. If we take the average of this, this is 5.428. This is different from the value that we obtained using this formula. Can you think why? Because the deviation should be closer. If that was 2, it should be say 2 point something or 2.5, like that. Even 3 is okay. Any one of you just try to guess because you all have, at least 50% of you know all the statistics. Please, it will be more interactive. Why it is not close to the average deviation? Anyone answer? Any guess? Please. This is very small group, only 15 students, so 14 IM 115th. 14 students are connected, so don't hesitate, just try to guess. And these 14 students are really serious to learn. This is because the average is not of the deviations, but the square deviations. So do we really want the deviation of the original values, then what we will have to do, we will have to do counter transformation. We have done transformation by squaring. So squaring has helped us to get positive value. So if we will get the square root, S-U-R-T is the formula, square root, and then take this number, square root, so it is very close. That was 2 and this is 2.3. So this is the logic of computing standard deviation. So let us define what is a standard deviation. You have seen here what I have done. I have taken the deviation of each score from mean. This is x minus m. Then I squared it. Then I calculated the average of this square deviation, and then I took the root. So, if I have to define this in words, then we say that standard deviation is root mean squared deviation. Mean is average. So, root mean squared deviation. And here I have written the formula. Sigma is generally used for population standard deviation, and SD is used like AD. SD is used, or S is used, for sample standard deviation. So here, what I have said verbally, let us see that here. Root, you can see root. This is square deviation divided by n. So this is root mean square deviation. Square deviation, this is square deviation. Sum all the square deviation divided by n, then what it will be? It will be mean of square deviation. And this is the standard deviation. So standard deviation is basically root mean square deviation. And I have used this formula. So I am finding difficult to write x bar, therefore I have used x minus m. But you think just that this is x minus x bar square. So we will compute x minus x bar square and divide it by the number of observation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 divided by 7. And this will be the deviation of the squared value, not of the original value. So to get the original units, we will do counter transformation. We will get the square root of this. We have done this. You can see the square root of this. And this is the standard deviation. Any question or query up till now? So, this is called standard deviation, SD, and this value is called the squared standard deviation, called variance. So, what is variance? Variance is the square of standard deviation. So, this is variance. So, if you will not take the value, this will be called variance, and if you will take the square root of this, this will be standard deviation. Now, In examination, we are most often required to do the computation. I am limiting this because in the recording it will be there and I am recording the session. And let us remove this highlight also. So, in frequency distribution or in group data, we do not know whether 20 has occurred 3 times, 22 has occurred 3 times, so we do not have the exact value of Vx. So, we calculate the midpoint and consider it as Vx. And how we compute midpoint? Can one of you tell the midpoint? This will, if you are not saying this, then it is really very demotivating for me. Can one of you say what is the midpoint of the first class interval?
Twenty-one, sir.
Very good. How you learned that? Very good.
The 20 plus 22 divided by 2.
Yeah. Very good. 20 plus 22 divided by 2. But the simplest way I suggested is that we take the difference, 20 to 22 differences of 2, divided by 2, 2 divided by 2 will be 1. And then this 1 is now constant. You add 1 in the lower limit. 20 plus 1 is 21. 23 plus 1 is 24. 26 plus 1 is 27. Another way is that if you have got any of the midpoint, then you add the size of the class. Size of the class here is 3. 23, 3, 26 plus 3, 29. So, just add 3 in 27, it will be 30. Or add 1 in 29, it will be 30. So, 32 plus 1, 33. Or 30 plus 3, 33. So, I am just writing this without taking 35, this will be 36. If I am doing any typo, then any one of you can correct me, otherwise it will remain there. Is any value incorrect? Or all the midpoints are, yeah. Please.
No, sir, the values are correct.
Oh, very much. So we have got X. Now we can use this formula with a little modification. We will have to calculate X minus X bar square and then we will multiply F. I have not written this formula. So, you can write down in your notebook that if we are using this raw score formula, we can just put a F, summation F into EX minus EX bar square. So, we will have to compute the mean of this data and then we will compute EX minus EX bar, then we will multiply by F. So, this method will take a long time in computation. So, the more simpler way is that, you know, we have not directly computed anything here. So, if we are using this formula for computing standard deviation, what we will require? We will require to square the value of x, that is the midpoint, and then after that, we will have two multiplications to get the value of fx square and fx. So, let us create one value. X square. We will simply write in superscript. Or let me try whether superscript is working here or not. It will take time. Let us do not waste time. So, this is x square. You write in the usual way. And x square is simply the, this is 21 raised to the power 2. So this is 21 square. In day, we will do the square of all the value. This is the value of x square. Now we have x, we have x square. In this formula, now we will require a fx and fx square. So let us create first fx, and fx, I am writing 2, you read it fx square, not fx 2. So fx will come, this is the f and this is the x. So we will do the multiplication of f, multiply it by x. This is fx. Do it for the remaining class intervals. So this is the value of fx. Here, many students, not all, a few students do commit error that they square this value. So they put the square of 63 here. This is not fx whole square. This is f into the square of the x. This is not the square of the fx value itself. So this value will come by multiplying f. So let us put the sign of equal to writing Excel formula. So f into, we have already computed x square value. So this is the fx square value. And now do it for the remaining cells. Here there is some error. Let us see why this is. Pandu. Again, this error is coming. Let us delete it. Write the formula again. 7 So I am able to detect why that error was occurring, but somehow I have corrected. I am also not sure whether all this, but I hope that these calculations will be correct. Now, to get summation fx, what we will do? Summation fx means summing this. So select this and let us do auto sum. So this value is summation fx. If we will sum all these values, this column, then this will be the sum of the fx square, and therefore this is the value of summation fx square. And here this 2 is a square, I was not able to put 2 here, so I have written here, please make a note and put it here. This is the whole square of this. So we have opted all the values required in this except n. From where n will come? If you will recall from the previous class, then sum of all the frequencies is basically the total number of observations n. So n is 35. So let us write the required things. N is equal to 35. The another value required is summation fx square. So how to write? I don't know. Sum fx square. is equal to 86940. 86940. And sum of fx is 1170. So if you will put all these values, so this will be SD is equal to, we will do the square root later on, so I am not putting a square root and calculating the variance. Then it will be summation fx square. Summation fx square is,
sir, you are not
896. I am able. Okay. Is there connection issue or voice is cracking or what?
The voice is cracking at some part of time.
So that means connectivity is. Let me increase the microphone voice. I have increased. Is it little better? Or still the same problem?
So better, sir. Better.
Please bear with me. These are the internet and other issues that are not under my control. 640. This is the value of summation fx square. And now we will divide it 35. I am not doing the actual division. I am just showing. And this will, from this we will subtract something else, and that something else is the value of summation fx. So the value of summation fx is, this is fx column, so the sum is 1170, and this will again be divided by n, that is 35, and this time we take the whole square of this. This will be the value of variance, not SD. But if we take a square root of this, then this will become a standard deviation. So this, we will have to do these calculation, and finally we will calculate the square root. The square root will be the last step in computation of a standard deviation. So, and also try to see here that this is nothing but the formula of the mean. Summation fx by n is the formula of mean. So this is basically the mean whole square. But in this way, the computation is little easier. Now let us do the actual computation. So I am doing this computation first. So this will be 89640 divided by 35. This is coming to 2561. Now let us do this computation. This is 1170 divided by 35, and this is 33.43. Now we will square it. So this value raised to the power 2. So this is the squared value. Squared value is coming to 1117. So I am again writing based on these calculations, SD is equal to, the first computation is, just see, 2561. 2561. Minus 111 7. And a square root of this. This I am writing. Then I will do the computation. So let us do this. So we will do it in two steps. So first do the subtraction part. 2561 minus 1117. I think there is some error. And when we will do the square root, so this is some error. An error in computation using formula. So square root of 2561 minus 1117, and then SQRT. This is 38, but this is not the exact standard deviation. I know, I can see the data. So we have made some error in this computation. Somehow this EX square and this multiplications, there is some error, and therefore this is not coming. So in next video I will save the computation of this, because there is otherwise just do it again without dragging the formula. Let us do it again without dragging the formula, and if we see that there any change, then it is okay. So this is the value of x. Let us do in a different way. 21 into again 21, 441. And also try to help me, because sometimes we do mechanical error and we are not able to find. So these are the squared value. And let us check this. This is 21, 24, 27, 30, 33, 36, 39, 42, 45. It is okay. So let us sum. Look, there is some error, because this symbol is coming, it means it is suggesting something, that there is something that cannot be done. So these are the steps. We will calculate the x, then we will calculate fx, we will also calculate the x square value, and we will sum, and we will put all these values in this equation. For this example, I have done this. And the standard deviation has come to be 7.348. Earlier, I was showing this computation, it was quite high, it was coming to 38, because some error occurred in the way of doing computation using formula. In this class, I was saying that I will share this formula in which we will reduce the value of x using the assumed mean. So, either I will interact with you, or I will just prepare one video for doing the standard deviation computation using shortcut method, and I will upload it. And then this part is complete. The one unit, that is the measures of central tendency and measures of variation, we have completed. And in the last unit, the chi-square test, there is one video I have already uploaded about the chi-square test. please go through that.